to Belgium, which is quite impressive. Well, I'm hosting the second biggest stage for the whole day, and I'll be closing it down between 10 and midnight as well. It's one of the world's most successful festivals for dance music. It features dance music across the board of everything, and it's a three-day festival. And they've been asking me for a few years to come, and we finally did the deal last year at Amsterdam Dance Event. I'm not really what you might call a people person. Wandering around festivals is not really my forte. So I'll be staying close to my festival area and being there. I've got quite a few interviews to do during the day as well. Also, you know, seeing the artists that I've booked. But it's just to relax and absorb the music of the arena that I'm in. Sometimes traveling can be a real pain in the ass for all artists. And sometimes it's just nice to be able to travel with a bit of comfort and relaxation. This will be my office during the day as well. You never know what to expect with the weather. There's rather a lot of clouds out there at the moment, but I think it should be okay. Have to wait and see. It's best not to expect too much and hope for a lot.
I love him. Dave, can I get down on my knees and lick your ass?
Not if you're facing that direction, you can do something else.
Okay. But I tell you what, he's got a bus. How'd you get that bus?
Telephone. You got a telephone, right?
Come on, man.
Agent.
What's her name?
Agent.
What's her name?
It's all about an agent, man.
It's a girl.
No, no.
One of them rich girls, right?
No, 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 no. You got a bus.
Yeah, right. It was fun, and I played an early set. I don't normally play early sets, but I like it, but it's different. There's a bit of a challenge there. The challenge is that people have been, you know, people are just walking in, just getting set up. They're not really sure where they're gonna spend their next couple of hours in the festival, so you really have to help them position their minds and their mentality to what they're gonna do for the whole evening.
And what did you try to do? How did you try to do that?
Just keeping my variety of music up, and, you know, just, tempo is important for me. I never try to go too fast. And if you want to really maintain control, you got to keep. If you want to keep the women involved, there's a certain tempo that women are attracted to. It's really serious. Like between 129 and 134, you could keep women. You start getting above that, you lose a certain kind of person. You know, so it's early in the day. People are still in the chill mode. So you want to play some very sexy, high-tech soul. Is probably one of the more professional festivals in the world. They do a beautiful job from the Michelin restaurant to top wines to great sound, very good stage production, stage managers, handlers, you know, backstage area, the way they treat the customer, the bracelets with the barcode concept. This is no joke. This is a revolutionary sort of next level festival. This will set, Tomorrowland tends to set a precedent for other festivals and how a festival should be run. Outside of Japan, I don't think anybody's doing it like this.
This is my first time here, and I played quite early, but after 15 minutes, I have to say, the place was almost full, almost you know, sort of, you know, packed, so that's why I'm happy now. I'm super happy and was very, very well. I just saw with the van some stages, and I have to say it's wonderful. It's really like to be in Alice in Wonderland or something like this. I love this. You are living a dream here with the music and you know, the stages and everything, the colors, the flowers. That's something very special. I never seen a festival like this before, you know. For me, festival is different than a club, because when I play in a festival, normally, you know, you play maximum 2 hours, 2 hours and a half. So you have to concentrate all the music in 2 hours or 2 hours and a half. And that's most difficult than a club, I think, because in a club, normally when I play, I can play also 5, 6, 7 hours. And you can go up, down, you know, you can do a proper trip. But when I'm in a festival, I kick it hard, you know, like I concentrate in 2 hours, all the best tracks I have in 1 month. Next, I'm preparing my new album. I'm doing the second album. The first was three years ago released. Now I will release the second one in the beginning of 2013. So yeah, I'm working hard in studio. Something is preparing, and my management is working hard for this. So, enjoy Tomorrowland, Dave Clarke, main stage. See you next year, maybe, or see you next time. Bye.
From a guy who lived in a garage and sold shoes for a living, don't you feel utterly privileged that you can play here? And I mean, a lot of people showing up to see you.
I do feel very privileged. It's amazing. It's I always believed that I would travel the world and do music. I was in the shoe shop and they were always saying to me, "Yo, what are you gonna do?" And I said, "Yeah, you know, I'm gonna travel the world and do music." I didn't know what the do part of the music was, but I just always believed that was going to happen. It's really strange.
Do you think anyone can do this?
What?
Be a successful DJ, musician, producer?
You know, I mean, let's be honest. It's not just about what your abilities are. It's also about luck. Luck in where you are, luck in where you grew up, luck in what your influences were. It's all about luck. And it's all about when you put that talent with the luck together, and hopefully something happens at the same time. And that's what's happened in my life, it seems.
Are there any things that you set out that you still want to do that you didn't do?
I want to go back in the studio again, which I'm doing, and I want to enjoy making music again, which I'm doing. I want to travel less, actually. I'm a little bit tired of traveling. It's quite tough. And I want to rebalance my life a little bit. As for career-wise things, I'm not sure. Just go with the flow with what I feel like I should be doing.
It's great being in Europe, and especially right here, we're in Belgium. I've been here for so many years, and it's good that I'm able to still play here. So I love it.
You've been around Belgium a lot of times, though. I mean, it's like one of the first places to give you a home in a way, right?
Yeah, it really is. But you know, throughout the years, I guess some venues they don't book me anymore, but it's good that there's different places that do and show me love and respect. And
what have you got up and coming? Have you got any new releases? What's going on with the Relief label?
Yeah, I'm working on a lot of stuff. I'm trying to get everything positioned in the right way for next year, basically, because it'll be Today, this year was the 20 years of Casual Records, and next year will be the 20 years of anniversary of Relief and Green Velvet.
You know, okay, so you're 20 years old?
I'm 19.
Okay, so you've been playing all these years illegally in venues because you were too young?
No comment.
How do you feel about the shift in the way that things sell now? I mean, are you happy with the way things sell digitally compared to what it was before with vinyl?
Well, you know, of course, there are certain things that were great about vinyl. I mean, I love just having the hardware and the cover.
But from a marketing point of view, from a record company,
mm-hmm.
wasn't it better for you to have vinyl than it is to just sell digitally, do you feel, or do you think that's rubbish?
I think you just have to be a lot more creative nowadays. You know, just like, say, for example, you doing this and doing your website, those are ways, those are creative ways that artists need to tap into to get them out there now. You know, it's a different era, so you have to move with the times and do things in a way that keeps the fans interested. It takes a little work.
Cool, man.
Oh, the gig was fun. The crowd was amazing. Dave was the best, you know. So,
what more?
No, I mean, as far as hosting it, you know, he had to make sure everything's organized, looking at all the DJs, and he took really good care of me. Well, he always has the best tour buses, you know. Every time I always show up in some little compact smart car or something, and then Dave shows up in his tour bus and always, you know, makes me look bad, feel bad, but that's okay.
But I look after him otherwise.
Otherwise, he takes really good care of me. He lets me come on his tour bus, so that's good.
That's 2 minutes, yeah.
Well, for me, Dave is one of my best techno heroes ever, and I follow him from since I started to listen music, the techno music, because he was actually the first techno DJ I ever heard in a place. So it was in Napoli, in Old River Park, in an amazing place that Dave knows very well. It was 2003, and I went there for the first time and was Dave playing. And I didn't have no idea about techno music. And Dave is one of them, was playing that day and make me like the techno music.